Hey guys, welcome to another lesson here. I'm GED. This is math, algebra, multiplication, and division. If you do appreciate my lessons, please go ahead, give me a thumbs up and like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Anyways, so there's a few main points I wanted to cover here when you are multiplying and dividing sine numbers or algebra. So we'll start here. For example, so with multiplication in algebra, they do not show, let me make this a little larger, they do not show like an X for the multiplication sign. Reason being is, I'm not sure why this isn't working. Okay, reason being is it can get confusing because they use X for variables, missing variables instead. So missing variable is basically a problem that you're trying to solve for. You're missing a number and the X will indicate the number that you're missing and you're trying to figure it out. So that can be confusing, okay, if you are using that for multiplication as well. So they show you here how they do it. So this is a negative 5, okay, times 6. So they can do multiplication with a dot, as you can see there. Okay, sorry, I'm not sure why it's showing this plus sign, but just think of the top of the plus sign as the pointer. So that's one way to write multiplication. Another way is just to put the numbers right next to each other, like 5 and 6. Okay, it can be, as you can see here, there's just one parentheses here. Here there's two parentheses, but they're still both right next to each other without any other symbols, so it means multiply. All these mean the same thing. They mean negative 5 times 6. Here again, negative 5 times 6, also negative 5 times 6. So there's, as you can see, several ways to write multiplication. Okay, so when you're solving a problem, algebra problem, you have, for example, well, let me just say what I'm trying to say first. So basically, here it says, if signs are the same, the answer is positive. So what they actually mean is, if you have pairs, okay, let me show you an example here. So for example, and this applies to the negative signs, okay? So for example, if you have, see these, all these signs are the same on number 22 here, right here. Negative 4 times negative 6 times negative 5, okay? They're all the same. So by reading this, you may think that the answer would be positive, but it's actually going to be a negative number here because it's actually pairs of similar negative numbers. For example, right here, this will be a positive number, okay, because it has one pair of negative numbers, okay. Also, if there were 4 negative numbers, it would also be positive. If it had 6 pairs, not 6 pairs, 6 with 3 pairs, which is 6 individual negative numbers, you'd still get a positive answer. So think of it as pairs. As long as you have pairs, it'll be positive. This one here, see how there's only one negative answer? No, actually this is a little bit different. They actually have 2 negatives right here, so that's awesome. But let's see another one. This 3 here is also going to be negative. Yeah, so that's pretty much that. Trying to think. Also, yeah. So there's also order of, well, let's do one of these, for example, to show you. So 12, let me bring up my calculator here to show you that this is going to be positive here. See, 12, remember, two numbers next to each other here, is this is not minus. This shows that it's a negative, okay? So 12 times 2. So different calculators, different. I found that this one, you have to first put the 2 and then the negative sign to make it negative. The calculator on my phone is actually, all I have to do is, well, you put the negative sign first. So 12 times negative 2 divided by, again, negative 2 equals 12. Okay, so as you can see, that was a positive number because we had two pairs here. Well, we had one pair, two negative numbers. This one over here, number 23, is, since there's one negative here, it's going to be a negative answer. So, for example, 50 divided by 2. Times negative 5 equals, as you can see, negative 125. Okay, so as you can see, that kind of applies to all of these here. Let me see what's next on this. Then we also have the order of operations, which they say first do multiplication and division. Okay, problem may contain two, that's this one. Order of operations, so it says do multiplication and division operations first, work from left to right, and then you do multiplication and subtraction. There is also these questions or these problems right here. Maybe looking at this and wondering, how do I do this problem? Because it's not like just from left to right. So what you do when there's a division bar in between this, which is what this is here. Let's go over that real quick too. So you can see here, in algebra, division can be written with the division symbol, but it is usually shown with a line that means divided by. So the expression 20 divided by negative 5, so that's how it'll typically show it. Show the line here, which means division, or a line, a forward slash like this, which also means division. Okay? So as we can see here, this problem is not only division because there's multiplication, but in the end you will be dividing. So we will do let's do this problem. 4 times, or multiplied by negative 4. This is going to be a negative number because there's only one negative sign there. Okay, be negative 16. Let me write that down. Negative 16. And then negative 8, this is going to be positive just by looking at it. Negative 8 multiplied by negative 2 equals 16. Okay. So, symbol there, but that was an accident. Okay, so 16 divided by 16 equals 1. Okay, so that is your answer. Sorry, I did that incorrectly. Negative 16. So we know this is going to be a negative number. Divided by 6t. 15 equals negative 1. So the answer for number 26 is negative 1. Be careful, guys. It's easy to forget steps, so just be real thorough and don't try and race through these, especially if you're doing a test, because as you can see there, I kind of forgot to add the negative there, and it came out to a positive 1. It should have been a negative 1, okay? So this is the same thing right here as you do it this way. 3 times negative 4 times 2 times 5. Then, since this you don't have any operations to do down here, you would just divide the answer that you got by 6. Okay? So, and one funny thing about this here is, well, it's actually not necessarily funny, but you can see it's going to be a positive number as well, because there's 2 negatives here. Okay, because if you do these here, you do this operation first before you divide it by 6, you'll get a negative number, because it was only 1 negative here, it's not a pair. Then you multiply or divide this number, the answer to this number here, by 6, which they're both negative, so then you will get a positive answer, okay? Let me give you that example. So we have 3 times negative 4 times 2 times 5 equals negative 120. Okay. Then we divide that by negative 6. We get a positive answer. We had 2 negatives. Negative 120 divided by negative 6. Okay. Let's see if there's anything else I can think of here. So, I think that pretty much covers it. Again, this is pretty simple. Just remember here, this is multiplication. Like, if there is subtraction, you won't see it in these parentheses here. You'll see it outside of the parentheses, okay? Let's do one of these problems here real quick. Okay, so Janice is creating a computer spreadsheet. A portion of her work is shown below, which is, using this information from the spreadsheet, what is the value of the expression A1? Okay, so we have, I'm going to write these down as we go along. So we have A1 is negative 3. Okay, times C1, which is 7, okay, let's do this here, 7, times A3, which is negative 1. So negative 1. Okay. Then we have to divide that. Well, let me see. Using the information from the spreadsheet, what is the value of the expression? Hint, in a spreadsheet, the symbol. So Janice is creating a computer spreadsheet. A portion of her work is shown below. Using the information from the spreadsheet, what is the value of the expression? Okay, so let's find the value of it. Let's continue doing what we were doing. So divided by B. No, I'm writing B. divided by B3 is 3. Okay, so let's do this on the calculator. Negative 3 times 7 times negative 1 equals 3 times negative 1. So 3 times negative 1 equals negative 3. Okay. So this is going to be a negative number, obviously, because we have only one negative here. Could have guessed it from here because there's 3 negatives. We need a pair. So let's do this. 21 divided by negative 3 equals negative 7. So we can see that B is going to be the answer there. Okay, negative 7. Anyways, guys, I hope that gives you a good idea of pretty much how to do these fractions. We did talk a little bit more about the number signs and stuff in the previous lesson, which I believe was lesson 28. So, anyways, if you enjoyed this and it did help you, leave a thumbs up and see you again next time.